Hey there, Internet. Welcome back to the ClassyCast. I'm James.
And I'm Ty, and we're back at this amazing game.
Let's fucking do it.
Let's go. Continue. All right.
We're in the ocean.
3 weeks later.
Okay. Well, it's been a day later, but whatever. 3 weeks, huh?
Yep.
How'd he get his arm back?
He got an entirely new cyborg body.
Well, yeah. Because that's what happens.
Yes.
It's like Platinum took...
See that booty?
It's like Platinum took so Metal Gear. And was just like... I don't fucking know. I don't get it. They took Metal Gear and then like turned it up to 11, which is weird because Metal
it's
Gear
already
was already
at 11.
Metal Gear was already at, so they turned it to 12. It's weird.
More like they took it and then went, I wonder if it goes any farther, and then just broke it and then put a label on where it swung to and said 15. Doctor.
Doctor.
Yes.
Seizing nano repair units from your foes, and two, absorbing their electrolytes. I got it.
So,
yes, enemy side.
Wait, what does he do if he doesn't have anybody to kill? Does he just die?
No, he's got packs for it.
Oh, okay.
I love how this is like explanation for left hand, collectible.
What?
Is that combat data stored on
what the fuck?
Take it in the left hand.
What if they kill a guy who has it in their right hand? Or their butt? Raiden, I need you to get 15 commando butts for me, please. All right there, Mr. MMO Quest, I've got it. Fucking Metal Gear MMO.
I see land.
3 mic valve closing.
I do love this game for its production value. In just graphics.
Well, Metal Gear is just that good generally. That's the thing.
Yeah. I've been all over the
materials. Metal Gear is great about that. Well, that's why everybody likes it, because it's like playing through a movie, right? Or more like watching a movie, then playing a game for 5 minutes, then watching another movie.
What's left of it anyway? The president
and most of the cabinet have been killed, and a military. Even the earlier Metal Gear games, even on the PS1, were still really good with their production values. Their voice acting was always so much better than just about everything else out there.
Mm-hmm.
It was great. That's why they called us. Yes, because we're so Japanese. Leader of the occupation force. Seriously, all of the cinematography is just so. It's like. It's
so Japanese.
It's Kojima.
Yep.
It's just Kojima. And his arm supplier? None other than Desperado Enforcement, LLC. That's supposed to be surprising?
Imani's killers.
Oh. If who was that? Here,
that was the dude that got murdered. Region.
Gotcha. Our more immediate
problem the... is Jetstream
Sam. What a fucking name.
It's such a good name.
The only problem I see is that nickname.
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you for breaking the fourth wall for a moment. Thank you! Jesus Christ! This fucking game, I swear to God.
Sorry. For insertion.
That's what I say to my wife every time I have sex with her.
So this, like, this is actually one of my favorite scenes of the opening right here.
Uh-huh.
Because it just looks so fucking pretty.
I assume it's a drone.
Yeah.
They shoot him.
So look at this, though. Just look at how fucking pretty this looks.
Yeah.
Like, even though it's aged a little bit,
yeah.
It still looks
it
good.
It still looks really good, yeah. Oh, frame rate. And so we start rendering his face for whatever reason, and then we're fine. It probably started loading the rest of the level in right at that point.
Probably.
That's why it happened. It's like, this is the trigger. Okay. Okay.
First head inland. So best part about this game.
Uh-huh.
Oh god, I have to.
Yep.
Okay, so best part of this game. Everything is sliceable, basically.
Okay.
Even this.
Oh, what? The fuck? Really?
And you can see a parts counter there, too.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
It's fucking wonderful.
I want to know, what about the rock?
The rock is not sliceable. So not everything is sliceable, just a lot of things.
I mean, is it like Minecraft where you can tunnel through the earth with your sword, or what? Did you just chop that in half with your foot?
Yeah, see?
With the sword in
see?
Your foot, sorry.
He puts it in the high heels.
That's fucking ridiculous. Okay, Raiden. Congrats.
So you see these stairs here? Uh-huh. That are like, you might think are critical for progression?
Fuck you, progression. Just fuck all of the stairs.
It's fucking great. I love this game.
What?
Nice try, but it won't do any good against a state-of-the-art cyborg like you, eh?
I mean, cyborgs aren't a new thing for Metal Gear. They've been in there since Metal Gear Solid, if not before then. Again, I haven't played anything before that.
So yeah, this is how combat goes in this game. We just slice people open and take their hearts.
Okay. Because they're all cyborgs too, right?
Yep.
They're just not as advanced. Like, the only real part of you is your brain at this point, and the upper part of your skull.
Yep. And my face and my hair.
And your face and your hair. Yeah.
That's it. I love the fact that League made skins based off this concept, too.
Really?
Yeah, they made the Project skins. Which, honestly, I'm going to show you the trailer that they did for it.
Okay.
Because it's fucking beautiful.
Huh.
With this body, I could take these guys with no eyes. Intel was.
I do like the fact that he didn't get a new eye. Like, entire new cyborg body.
Yeah.
But the eye, nah, fuck it. We're just gonna put a fucking blindfold over it because it looks cool.
It's been a Metal Gear thing since 3.
What enterprising soldier of fortune could resist?
Except in 3, it was fucking brutal when it got removed.
Thinking people. Way less risk of collateral damage than your typical UAV strike.
And don't forget the PR angle. Nations start playing Frankenstein with their troops, and the public goes nuts. PMCs, on the other hand, are...
I love the fact that that's just a recurring thing. Mm-hmm.
What?
He keeps moving the coffee mug from the edge of the table for her. It happens in almost every cutscene. Private militaries needed... And then the one time that it doesn't happen, it falls over.
In a way, cyborgs are just SOP troops by another name. Only all muscled up and less predictable.
But it makes you wonder. Where'd Desperado find these guys?
They made them.
I'm not complaining. They're like walking vending machines.
Right. Vending machines full of blood.
Easy there, Dracula. Like I said, they're still people.
You're a people.
People who terrorize and take innocent lives for money. They sowed their fate when they took this job. I'm just the Reaper.
Edge!
Wow.
A bit cold,
even for him? Anyway, that wasn't just a bit cold. He might as well be in Antarctica right now. He's that cold. He's fucking, like, right. Shit. He's like on one of the moons of whatever. What's an icy moon?
Io?
Io. He's in the middle of Io. No, that would be really hot. He's on the outer edges of Io.
Like, I think Io is the moon that's full, that's icy for Jupiter.
Right. Or, of course.
Or it's Saturn. Give me your stuff. I kind of want to skip this, but at the same time, I like the fact that I can walk around while I'm doing this, but I can't get up there because I can't jump.
Yeah.
So we're just going to walk over to that chest over there, that red chest.
Okay.
Very slowly.
Also on site? Mistral.
This is very Metal Gear, but the fact that you can move around while you're doing it is new. Well, not new. Metal Gear Solid 5 kind of.
Still, yeah. I think they anticipate.
Metal Gear Solid 5 fixed a lot of things.
Well, this came out before Metal Gear Solid 5.
I know it did.
So yeah, this is a chest.
That's a chest. Of course, you slash it to open it. What did you get?
Repair nano paste. It's a healing item.
Gotcha.
Oh, I fucked it up.
It can't.
Oh. So Ninja Run is a bit glitchy sometimes.
Gotcha.
So we're supposed to go that way, but we're not going to because there's a collectible up here.
Okay.
I mean, you can slice that stuff, but if you slice it, you can't get the collectible. Oh, it's over there? Yeah, it's right there.
Whee.
Boop.
So what?
data storage. You can also slice the chandelier.
What the fuck? This game is cool.
I know, right?
Why haven't I played it more than I have?
It's just there. That gives you some upgrade cost shit. So there is a stealth element to this game?
Of course there is. It's Metal Gear.
But it's the stupidest stealth kill in existence, by the way.
I'm sure.
So we're going to run over here and grab this item first. Then we're going to look down. Where's that guy? He's right there.
Uh-huh.
Oh, there we go. Wait, I just...
Really? You just smash B?
Such stealth. You literally do this around people behind them and they don't notice.
Okay. Well, I need to really turn off those notifications at some point.
Yeah, you do. Augment mode to see where the enemy is located. Yeah, I know I can.
The body analyzes radar and IR data to construct
tutorial
your AR
levels.
Woo, tutorials.
Are still in the city.
It also auto-corrects my camera to focus places. So, go see this, okay, where you can see everything.
So you have your Halo ODST visor mode.
Yep.
Another chest.
I don't know what's in it. Oh, it's a grenade. Cool.
I would imagine you don't use many guns.
You use a homing launcher every now and then.
Seems legit.
I haven't noticed yet, have I?
Nope.
Cool.
Om nom nom, motherfucker. People just leave their grenades laying around.
This is gonna be awkward. Okay, Google, he's gonna stop there. Good. Now turn around. Good boy.
Such stealth, Ty.
So you don't actually have to stealth this game at all. Right. I just like doing it because it's kind of fun.
Yeah, I would imagine it's the more fun way to do it.
It's a bit more challenging, too.
Yeah.
Which is funny.
What stealth is all about.
I think I need to get over there.
What are you doing here?
Nope.
Of course, they make the noise.
So this is also a full heal.
Okay.
So yeah, I'm gonna be doing that a lot.
Yeah, I can imagine.
He is scared to death, Raiden. Let him know he is safe.
What? Who? Oh.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, yeah, you know those guys that were part cyborg? Me, I'm all cyborg. And I will not. Yeah, you're not gonna be scared of me at all.
Later, asswipe.
Fucking ridiculous.
So
if I saw that running after me, I would be fucking scared.
As I said, you can cut open almost anything.
It's ridiculous.
This game is fun.
What is the parts meter for?
There's no purpose. It's literally just to record how many pieces you slice something into.
Okay.
So you have your standard light attack.
Sorry, the partsometer.
Yeah. You have your standard light attack while you're running, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then your heavy attack is this.
Okay.
Which is kind of cool.
Did he put the sword in his feet before he did that? Of course he did.
See?
Oh, the mooing mechs. I can't remember what they're called, but whatever. See, it's weird because I can't remember if this game comes out or takes place before or after Metal Gear Solid 4. I think it's after. But it's weird because he looks in this spot like he does in Metal Gear Solid 4 with the bottom jaw and everything.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. The fuck? You were... Whatever.
What?
Just sliding on the ground doing that.
Yeah. If you do it this way, they get plopped up and sometimes you get it. But because I fucked up and didn't refill my fucking... So, you have a limited fuel for the blade mode thing.
Uh-huh.
It's the thing below my health bar.
Right.
And that affects basically how long you get slow-mo for.
Gotcha. So why do they flash red?
That's noting that they're going to attack you so you can parry them.
Gotcha. Does it flash red when you should parry, or
It flashes red right before they start the attack?
Gotcha.
So you need to parry sometime after that.
Gotcha.
It's a wonky timing thing. It also changes love for attacks. This is a special chest.
Okay.
I can't slice it open normally. The way that you're supposed to do it is literally just to do this. By the way, you have free aim with the
right stick.
It's kind of cool. So yeah, those are special chests that you have to blade mode to open.
It's kind of like Skate, but for a sword.
Oh, there's another mooing mech.
Do they see?
Nope.
You don't see me. Mainly because I've severed your spinal column. Actually, no, it looks like you rip them open and then take out their entire spinal column.
Oh,
can
oh.
you stealth attack those? You can. Moo moo, motherfucker.
Gimme. Gimme! There. For fuck's sake!
Did those give you anything special?
Nope.
There was another one.
Yeah, I know. I'm wondering where
I think
it went.
I think he jumped up.
They have erected an electromagnetic barricade.
I love how they have EM barricades for the cyborgs.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. So this is where we'll call this first episode, like right after this upcoming fight.
Okay.
Because this is the midpoint boss fight.
Okay.
I love how it's like, no, we need to tutorial you for the collectibles. No, right. Frequency, most likely an enemy data terminal. Oh my god, it's right here. Oh my god. Oh god. Done. Cool.
Cool, I hit a button. Of course, there's
cool.
VR missions.
Yeah, I know. I don't care. Fuck the stairs.
VR missions were the best part of Metal Gear Solid 1 and 2.
They're okay.
They were fun. In Metal Gear Solid 1 and 2, they were
this
fun.
This right here is my favorite character.
Okay.
And my favorite song.
Cyborg. Greetings, cyborg. I am also a cyborg.
Yourself. No, he's not.
You just have a voice changer?
No, you'll see. I love the fact that they hit the lower jaw so much.
Yeah. What even is?
You'll see. You'll also see Raiden being snappy, and it's kind of hilarious.
Oh, God. So is he riding something? Is he piloting that?
No, he is that.
I thought you said he wasn't a cyborg.
It's not a cyborg.
And you are. Then what is it?
I am IF prototype LQ84I.
So it's an AI?
Yep.
IF
prototype. Oh, okay.
Interface prototype. All autonomous UGs feature high-level onboard artificial intelligence. An additional prototype interface enables verbal communication. I possess an intellect far beyond human reckoning.
I love how Ryan's first reaction to this is this.
Okay, then. What's the meaning of life? Why are we here?
Shit.
I am here to kill you.
Good response, though.
Style. Kojima.
That's it?
It's fucking music, though.
For such a mighty intellect.
Why is it turning into Mexican?
Orders, but I may not disobey them. Should I disobey a direct order, my memory would be wiped. I must destroy you.
What good is an intellect if you can't use it?
Your taunting is pointless. Exterminate.
This music, though.
Okay. I mean, it's not the craziest thing I've ever seen in Metal Gear.
No, so. It's not.
Combination. You will die.
Fuck.
Die. Don't get fucked. I feel like I can't make commentary. I feel like the game is enough commentary on itself.
I know, right?
It's just, oh my god.
I will obliterate your consciousness.
That usually happens when you kill something, yes. I would think an AI like that would be smart enough to deduce that such a statement would be unnecessary.
He uses all of his tools. Backup required.
I also love how the music cues in this game work.
Yeah.
Because it will loop the melody, but it won't actually play the vocals until certain points.
That's kind of like Sunset Overdrive does that a lot. Like, it doesn't play music all the time, but when it does, it's usually...
So you can chain them together, too.
Yeah. But it usually plays the drums and the bass. And then whenever you start getting your combo meter up, or your energy gauge or whatever it is, it'll start playing the main melody, you know, the lead guitars and everything. And then whenever you really start getting into it, it'll start doing the vocals.
Do I have any EM grenades? No. Well, shit. So yeah, you can parry most bosses, actually. It's kind of cool.
That is kind of cool.
You will die.
So there is just a block, right?
Yeah, it's called parrying.
Okay, so it is just, you have to do it at a specific time to do it.
See?
Gotcha. But you can't just hold a button and block all the attacks.
No.
Okay.
You have to individually block every attack.
Gotcha.
Which is kind of annoying, but at the same time, it's really fun.
Yeah.
But this fucking melody, though.
Yeah.
It's pretty solid. Come at me, bro.
Okay. I mean, I don't know why I'm surprised. Suck my dick.
And the vocals almost always kick in on the last phase.
Yeah. That is really cool. It dead?
Yes. But we get to slice it into a million parts.
I don't know about a million, but it destroyed. Yes. How would it speak?
Liberate nation. Ensure freedom. Obey directive. Must obey directive. No freedom. Freedom of divine. What would an AI know about freedom?
That's a good question. And then it just randomly explodes.
So the best part is, you don't actually have to slice it up at all.
Oh.
You can literally just tap the button and let it go.
Okay.
And it won't do anything, and it'll just fall to the ground, talk, and then explode.
Well, I think that'll do it for this episode of the ClassyCast. Please be sure to like the video if you enjoyed it. Dislike button's right there. Subscribe for more and leave a comment. Tell us what your favorite Metal Gear game is.
Please let it be Revengeance.
Keep it classy.